There are many ways to change the time range or the x-axis on a trend. You can use the zoom function that we described earlier. You can use the one time period forward and backward buttons, or you can use the scroll bar, or finally you can use the change time range dialog box. I'd like to illustrate how each of those work. The zoom control will change the x-axis appropriately. We saw that earlier. We can revert back. The one time period back will look at the time range of the trend and go back one unit. This particular trend happens to be an 8-hour trend, so every time we click that time range one time period back, we go back 8 hours, and thus every time you click on one time period forward, you go forward in time 8 hours. Again, the revert time range will return the trend to its original state. You also have a scroll bar up at the top, and this will allow you to move through time, although the scroll bar sometimes isn't as fine of a control as you might like. Any changes you make there can be nullified by using the revert time range. Finally, the change time range dialog box will allow you to zoom in on any period of time where there's data, whether it be yesterday or last week or last year, by simply putting in a specific date and time for the beginning and the end. That would be the from and to. Or you can use a relative time notation to indicate your beginning and ending of your trend. Keep in mind that any changes made to the time ranges in run mode are strictly ad hoc or temporary. They will not be saved with the file.